Hello everybody, and today this video is going to be about using Windows 2020, I mean Windows 2000 and 2021, and it's going to be trying to make this old computer try to get close to what people would use every day. So like, basically we're turning this into a machine for your grandma, or for someone who doesn't understand. So what we're going to do is, first I got some programs that we're going to be doing here to make it newer, make it used more. So this is a virtual machine with Windows 2000. I think I put 2 gigabytes of RAM in here, 4 gigabyte hard drive, which really is almost close to not enough. So we go to here, we've only got a gigabyte and 30 left. So, yeah, so, and we do have guest editions installed, so I can make it full screen so it fit on little devices instead of the monitors that I have to use for older virtual machines like Windows 98, since those don't have the ability to use guest editions because they don't have support for them. So that's why I have that, and I guess to make it easier, but okay. So without further ado, let's get to the video. So I do have this shared folder. This is what I use so I can get things from my host computer to this computer without converting everything into a CD file. It makes it easier. It's just the internet, whatever they call those things. Internet. So yeah, it just shares over the internet. So what we're probably going to do first is probably change the background to something more modern. I like that. Kinda. Okay. We'll keep it at this, I guess, for now. Okay. So what I got here is Firefox. I have Internet, this is like a extra, but I have Internet Explorer since this, it's doing that thing again. This has Explorer, we wait. Let's go to a, there it goes, now finally loaded. We have Internet Explorer 5, so that's going to update that to Internet Explorer 6, which really was the last version that you could get for Office 2000. And then we are going to be installing Office 2000. So kind of put some things that we do modern, we find their old versions, and we put them on old computers. So let's first start off with Firefox. Now, I've not installed these yet, so they're installing while it's being recorded. Next. Yes. I don't know if, well, we might not run out of space. Yes, let's launch it now. Let's see how it turns out. There was nothing on there anyway, so no need. Right. Restricted. So let's see if we can go to .com. Okay. No, yeah. Oh. Yes, I know. Yes, we can Google some things. Let's go to google.com. See, it's old versions. So, yeah, we can hop on the internet now. So, let's see. Can we go to a modern homepage like bing.com? Okay, it's very, hang on, let me see what the colors are. Real fast. Oh, we want 32-bit color. And we want whatever's normal. supply. It might need to restart a machine. Oh. No. No, leave it, leave it, leave it. Okay, I guess it ain't gonna work. We'll take what we can get. That's also old. So yeah, let's see here. Let's just type in a random thing. So let's go to, youtube.com. Let's see, can it open it? Nope. But this is like the only, oh, I don't know. Can we get Opera? I do have an old Opera beta. Okay, so yeah, now we can start browsing normal today web. So, where do people go to? Let's go to office.com. Okay, let's just type in office. I guess we have to wait. I guess we put too much pressure on it or whatever. Let me see if I can find that old Opera on my desktop real fast. Eventually it'll just ask for me to close out in now. So yeah, we can do normal today browsing. But let's not go back to that site. No, 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 no. Where are some other sites? Okay, we're done here. I can't think of anything else to have fun with on this. Okay, next is going to be updating our internet browser since we have version 5. I guess it's kind of installed everything. Okay, put a folder on our desktop. Open it up. Let's see here, if I click this again, it says, oh well. So let's get in here. No. Hang on, we're still on the version 5, yeah. Oh, here it is, setup IE6. Accept. Oh, wrong one. To update internet browser, yes. Looks like those will take forever. might pause it and wait for it to. Oh, never mind. Finished. So now what? I guess in now. Oh, it's gotta restart. Okay, we'll start. Oh, that's my spray smelly thing that scared me. Now it's working. Oh, browsing. Oh, it's got to set up our new browser. Oh, did I mute it? I might have muted it. I know sometimes it doesn't want to play the beginning sounds or the sounds when it opens windows. So, did everything load right? We still open number 5. Oh, that changed. There's no more 5 there. I think it did update. Yep, version 6. We have updated our Internet Explorer. What is the latest? That's a I'll search it up later. Oh, what's this? Yeah, we'll go to. Well, while we wait, I'll, since I know you have to, like, add driver support and you have to, and it's, you have to find files to convert normal files into ISOs. So how I found a way to transfer files was I created a new file. So, oh, whoops. So I went to new folder. I made a folder. I went to properties. I went to sharing, and I put share this folder. And then you can make the name whatever you want. Allow maximum, and then you gotta go to permissions and make sure that for everyone it's all is checked. And then you gotta go to apply. Alright, and then on my main computer, oh, it's not showing up. Hold up. Sometimes first you would need to, because yeah, right now, hang on. There was a thing where it would show in the computer area, it would show Windows 2000. So let me figure out what's going on. So computer, control panel. So yeah, that's how you do it. Or, so like you would, so yeah, here's my computer's network. This connected to my computer, and then I also created a share folder where my computer connected to the computer. Because I didn't know that it worked first. So, oh, okay. Control panel. Network. Connections. Well, I guess that's how you could do it. You would have to fiddle around with it yourself. I watched videos of how to do it for 98, and I had to fiddle around. Because there's a lot of things you had to change. And then also, there's a way you can do it the other way. So what you do, what is this here, you would find a drive. So like, here's my computers. If you'd find you, so for user, it's what it would be. So what we would do, we would go to map, a new drive. You would type in what it is. So, oops. For this one, this is and then you would slash the folder's name and then you click OK. But before you click OK, sure it's reconnected login. And then also, let me open up my control panel. Here it is. Oops. So you would do, come on. So what we would do here is we would go to network and sharing. Oh no, oops, this is the other one. Internet options. Oh, I don't know why that's coming up. Oh, oops, I know why. I gotta find it myself first. Let me find this on my own. I'll pause it. Okay, I was right. So what you need to do is you need to go to advanced sharing settings. What you need to do is make sure everything's off. That's just off because I selected that. Network discovery on. Turn on. Then you go to networks. What you have to do is you have to put right here, enable file sharing for devices that use 40 and 56-bit encryptions. Older devices, like 2000 and down, like me in 98, will not be able to find it because they only have 40 and 56-bit encryption. So, in order to have old devices find it, you would need to enable this, and then make sure password's turned off. Which, like, I already have that set, and then next, if you would go down to your search bar on your toolbar, which sometimes you need to enable it, you gotta do turn Windows features on or off, and then you open that, and then you'll get this window. Alright, you need to scroll down until you find this. MSB 1.0 file sharing support. You need to click that, and then you'll have to restart your computer. And then, so now, what we need to do on this is we need to type in the actual thing, hit finish, which really it's already found it. So hang on, do we have two now? Oh, we do. I'm going to disconnect this one. So now, you'll be able to view all your normal things like that. So that's how I found a way. Now, okay, let's check back in with this. Alright, it's obviously not working. So, okay, now our second thing that we had in store, well, the main thing, we're going to delete this real fast. Okay, so our next main thing was download Office 2000. So I already got the first CD inserted into our CD drive. So what we need to do is click it. Now we're going to get this. Yes, it's already got initials. Yep. So for our CD key, now I have a thing right here. Can we just copy and paste? Oh. Okay. Here, I'll just type it in as we go. Okay, oh, changes. Alright, so. Now, this should work. See, and it does. And then I'll put a description, a link in the description of where I got this from. Accept. Let's run do install now. Now this, yeah, off. This is Office Professional 2000. And then eventually it's going to ask for CD2. I don't know when yet, because this is new to me too. I'm going through this as we go. I didn't do anything ahead of time. Let's see here. Let's go to programs. That should be the new internet. Oh, it added these. Oh, yeah, I forgot. It's already added. I forgot. Why did it say I need to use disk 2? Let me insert disk 2 real fast. And let's see what that does. That says disk 1. Disk 2. Let's see what came with this. Oh, this looks like the same thing. Oh, maybe it's not. If it is, I'll get the key back. This will be a lot faster. See if he'll just reinstall. It's custom. Let's see what's happening. I guess next. Oh. Okay, I guess it's going to install part 2 of all this stuff. So, wait, don't we already have... Oops. Let's see, do we have publisher already? No, so I guess, yeah. Yes, there is a reason for part 2 of the disc. look at what we got. Why does we look for now? Okay, we got access, Excel. We got the tools, normal tools. Oh, hello, that's me. Oh, because it's adding more things. Okay. Okay, so we got everything running now, so let's try Excel. Oh, hello. It's the clippy person thingy. Sure. Oh, I do not have an existing file. Let's create a new. Yeah, we'll just do a normal database. Create. Alright. Field name. Oh, it has options. Text you entered isn't an item in the list. Sure. Oops, I spelled that wrong. I guess, yeah, there it is. So yeah, there's Excel, and then we have the clippy person. Oh, there's icons. What about Bob? Oh, they have different things. Did I hear a mouse? Oh. Okay, I want to see what this one is. Welcome. Desire help on any of the aspects. Click here. Click the office logo whenever you need help. I can assist you with any work on your electronic space. Reading status, ready for instructions. I'm here to help, so give me a click if you need anything. Then we're back to Clippy. Hey there. What's the word? I guess we got options. So yeah, we have Clippy. Didn't they make like an animated movie? Not like a movie, but I mean like an animated little video of like what happened to him in Office 2000 or 3 or something. Or Office XP. Alright, so let's get out of here. Yes, let's save our changes. Let's call this. Yeah. Tail. There is my primary key to find yes. Oh, he's still here. Hello. Bye. What's this? I don't know why that was there. Documents. Here's our database. Well, let's open it back up. Open, we opened a whole new thing. Oh, it came with pictures. Alright, let's go to our next thing. Oh, here it is. They added some new things. New office document. And then we can pick what we want. Let's get out of there. And open an office document. So, let's open that. Oh, here's our database. When we did any number ID. That was an option. I didn't see anything. Auto number. Okay. And there's Clippy. Hi. I'm gonna put you back in the corner. All right. Let's go to next. Excel. Now, I did need a quick Excel. For example, of them all. Of an example of like all my computers that I own. Oops, now we gotta wait. Well, we can view some things, so let's call this one. Oh, never mind, it's already cancel. can do things like, here it is. Here's my, fit it in here. Here's my Excel of everything. You know, let me see if I can get this file to save. Forgot wherever this file is. Okay, yes. Let's see here. Let's make a copy. Now let's put it in my shared folder with the VM paste. So yeah. And then we can select it all. With him. Nope, we are not, but we will go in our shared folder. Let's see, will Excel open this? Let's see, I can see it. Here it is, Excel for Windows. Let's open that in that. It's not a recognizable format. Okay, I guess it never opened right. This is off the office that I did make this originally on was Office 2010, because that's what I have. Let me open it. Let's see if there's a way out. I know that they can have it readable. Like there's an option where you can move it back to a readable position. Let me go figure that out real fast. Is locked for editing. Okay, so I just think I put it in the format. Copy of computers. See, now it's in a format that it can read now. Let's close out of that. So yeah, now I found a way, a version, well, up in a file format that normal things can read. So yeah, this is what I wrote. These are all my computers. And these are the things about them. One has a none. Oh, I was making sure that I messed that up. So yeah, these are the ones that I have. What does this say? Dot, not dead, but not used. Oh. Yeah. So yeah, we can open normal files. Here. Let's go. Let me. Is there a way I can select all? Hold up. Never mind. That didn't work out. We tried Excel, we tried their snapshot, but it says, I think this is wanting disk 1. Now let's click OK. Ah, here we are. Snapshot viewer. I have no snapshot takes right now. Okay, so shortcut bar. Let's try that. If you do like to configure the okay. Oh, that's cool. So kind of like it's right here. Auto hide with that. I might keep that actually on. So let's see here. Looks like this new message, new appointment, task, journey, new note. What's new note? that's Outlook email. This is, and then if we want to create a new, there we are. So yeah. Nope. Bye, Clippy. Alright. Let's see here. What else we got? Hold up. I have, let's see. Let's see if I have that too. Let's go to Outlook. It won't work since, what is this? Oh. We can do one. It'll need a SMS, so. msn.com smtp.sns.com. Yes. Yes. Okay, would you like to email? Okay, so I guess let's make an email to Pro. I think, what's it called now? Outlook. Yeah, Outlook. We'll send that. That probably ain't gonna work. But then, I will, just for the heck of it, open up my Gmail for it. Already it didn't work. I didn't expect it to. I just figured for the heck of it. Oh. Here, welcome to, my dog's barking. Welcome to Express 8, or it's full screen, actually. I don't think I'm getting any more emails, so there's no need to, what do you want? Nope. Okay, where was I? Okay, Outlook Express email. Solution for all your messaging needs. Emails, news group, multiple accounts and identities, HTML, messaging support, address book, and directory services, offline synchronization, improve index inbox rules, internet features, try to read that please, oh, free trial. Z-key. Sure. Oh, we got an inbox. Oops. Okay, so that's Office 2000. PowerPoint. File. Okay. you're all my different ones. Okay. So I see what this does. Is there an picture? Let me do something real fast. Okay, I just made a little mini slideshow. Here's my slideshow that I made in Office 2000. Windows 2000, Mega, and Windows. And there's this little icon of the thing. What is it? Okay, next. Their Windows logo is the same as 98, well really 95, oops, to 2000, and then they changed the logo at Windows XP. And in the start menus, it's pretty much the same from 95 all the way to Windows 2000. So, yeah. And here is what I did it. That's what. So there's my slideshow. We're going to save desktop. We're going to save that. So, there's... Alright, let's go to whatever's next. Word. Okay, so here's Word. That's paper. Oh, cool. See you. Yeah, let's do that. Hello, this is me. Rating. So, yeah, I guess they did have. So, let's see here. Let's see here. What did they make? So, yeah, this is where, I guess, time where they would fix your spelling mistake. So, there's a spelling mistake. He likes a stick. And then, let's see here, I will save this file. And I will save this desktop, shared. I'll save that there on my other computer. I'll open it on my computer. We gotta wait for the program to open. I think the reason it's slow is because I have 2010 on a Windows 10 machine. So that might be, while it's a little slow opening my Office. No, did it even open? I think it gave up. Oh, there it is. Okay, so here it is. We're about to open it. Here it is. It's, I guess read the conversion only. So, I guess, we'll save as then. But at least we can open something that's old. Saved it. We should be able to edit it. So now, this is me writing back from Office 2010 on and Windows 10. And I'm going to save this file. We're going to save it. And then we're going to see if I can open it. I can open it on the old computer. Let's close. Shared. Here, this is the one we want. Yeah, sure, read only. But hey. Oh, we're editing now. This is the again. Writing on Office 2000 on a Windows 2. Come on. Keyboard I'm not used to. This is old keyboard. Since I have to move over in the area where it's quiet in the house. On Windows 2000. Oh no, we won't read that. Never mind. Oh no, I don't think it'll save. Yes, we'll save this. And we'll just call it. There it is. And if we want to open it again. Oh, nope. There it is. We'll just have to keep creating more files if we want to just keep going. So, that's Office. A Word. Is there anything else? We got Publisher. Publisher, I don't really know what to do. Does this Office a Publisher? Because I've never used it. It does, but I've never used Publisher before. So, let's. So, I've. Just one way to learn today what it is, I guess. Okay, it looks like we're making a book. Or a get well card or something. Start wizard. Wizard will fill you. Wizard! This wizard, you will fill in your name, address, and other information for you so you don't have to enter it each time. Click OK first. So what am I doing? The wizard is available to help you design, publish, or create. Okay. Welcome to present. Blah. Good question. Ready to edit. What next thing do? Sure, I'll take the waterfall color. Sure. Yeah. I guess we can finish. Oh. We'll put back there. Call this BTT. Spell wrong. Oh, space. I don't think there's a space. Oh. Remember, this is all before YouTube, I guess, so yeah. I will correct that. We'll add this to my dictionary now. Just about to learn what YouTube is. Oh, and follow me. And then I'm going to put an arrow for like next page. I think this is what we're doing. Come on. Alrighty. Is that what I have no clue what we're doing? I don't know what this is. There's next. I guess we'll save it. Oh, design. Oh, Oh, this is the colors that I just answered. Save. Desktop. Yeah, sure, what you shared. Alright. Can I get out of that? Go back into shared, it'll be there. Somewhere. Here it is. I do not have a printer, because this is a VM. Okay. So yeah, we've had some fun. Let me add all these. Oh, that we can get rid of. Nope, we can move copy a printer. Oh, a sharing violation. More sharing violations. I guess ones that I've made I can move out. Alright. And then here are pictures that I used in the PowerPoint. Alright. So yeah. This video may have to be an hour long. I'm trying to make this a more newer program. I mean, so yeah. We do about what most people would do. We could on day-to-day browse the web, check out our emails, like AOL.com or whatever people do. I like how it all of a sudden changes that. So, oh, what's this? No, we are not restore. So yeah, people, I guess, usually go to AOL. Yeah, we can. Well, I guess you shouldn't do more than one at once. More than one tab at once. Because now it's going to be real slow. And then we can also do some office things. So if we need to create a Word program. So if we need to, we can do like. Slash button. There it is. Slash. RAM. Nah. What else would people make? Mine goes to church. So. So yeah, we create great and we'll go with this and our screen's fine. Flippy, you're making this real hard to use. No. If we need to, we can check our emails that, I guess for old people, if we need to, we can create a PowerPoint. As I know, PowerPoints make it sometimes easier for people to use. Because I know, like, for labels, I use PowerPoint to make labels for boxes and folders. If we need to, we can bring Excel for, like, if, I don't know, we got get-togethers and we need to know how many bread. No, what do they eat on get-together? Burgers. No. Burgers. One. We have five. House. Oh, no. Yeah, like that. Clippy. Takes so forever. And, let's see, what else does Office provide real fast, just for a sum up? Access, so.
I guess,
you want to play a little bit of solitaire with yourself. So yeah, we can do what normal, what I think normal, not does, not use a computer for everything, not for everyday's use. I think a person could live with this and still be able to do things today. Because they can still browse the web. Did I ever open these? You can still browse the web. You can do office stuff. So I say, this was a very successful video. This was a very successful video. I usually expect things to have to pause because of something, or something crashes, like it did last time I tried to make a video. I went 30 minutes and found out that the recording software wasn't even working right, crashed. So yeah. I'll hopefully do a 98 version of, well, not using it today, but at least how, and then, but I'll have to use a different monitor, so it won't come out like it is now. It'll come in more of a boxy, not triangle, rectangle form. It's more of a boxy, because I have to use a monitor, because how it works, it doesn't have the right, it doesn't show up right on my laptop, because that's what I'm doing this from. Well, this was a very successful video. I'll see y'all with another one.